moving into a world where we just expect that wherever we are, you know, computation will be done on our behalf to solve some problem for us. And increasingly, the thing that does it will know a lot about us, and that information will be shared across all the other things that we interact with. So if I think about using my phone, you know, I'm reading my email on my phone. I might then set it down and start reading my email on my, you know, new Microsoft Surface, which I just got on Friday.
Which he has with him if you would like to steal it.
And or I could just, you know, go to my desktop. And I might actually have all those things in the same place, right? Just as you've got your phone and mm-hmm. your laptop here. And I don't, and in some sense, the notion of email, what it is that I'm actually doing, is in a sense independent of the applications on the individual devices. And I just use whatever thing is in front of me that's convenient. You know, there's a joke that people tell about cameras that, you know, what's your best camera? It's the one you have with you, mm-hmm. right? And I think this is sort of the way we're beginning to think of computing. Mm-hmm. We've reached a point now where we've really given the computer the same senses that we have, right? So they have a sense of touch, they have vision, right? And Kinect was really the first mass market sort of 3D real-time computer vision device. They have the ability to hear. They know when they're being moved, so they have a sense of motion, accelerometers. They have a sense of where they are, better than we do actually, because they have the GPS. They can find themselves much more easily than we can. And so, in a sense, you know, because of that, they have, and of course they have access to all the internet. So now they have a lot of information that lets them do things on our behalf or to know what we need done for us.